Let's conduct a simple experiment, best done with a set of stereo headphones. Okay, you ready? I'll play a tone at 95 Hz. This sound wave is pulsing 95 times a second. Here's another tone at 88 Hz. If I play both sound waves together, each through a different speaker, you'll notice that they create a slow pulsating sound of a lower frequency. The resultant sound wave has a frequency equal to the difference between the two applied sounds, here creating a 7 Hz waveform. These waveforms have many names, and they all demonstrate one key principle in physics. Energy is neither created nor destroyed. When two waves interact together, they combine into a lower frequency wave with a max amplitude equal to the combined amplitude of the two waves. Your left and right outer ear is funneling these two sound waves into each ear canal, and your eardrums are vibrating with these waves, each slightly out of phase with the other. Connected to the eardrum are three tiny bones inside the ear known as the ossicles, which vibrate at that same frequency as the sound wave and amplify it on its way to the cochlea. The cochlea is the size of a small pea and is filled with fluid, sound waves traveling better through water. Inside the cochlea, stereocilia sit at the top of hair cells. As groups of stereocilia oscillate with the sound waves propagating through the cochlea, they emit ions which cause the release of neurotransmitter chemicals at the base of the hair cells they rest on. Right now, during this experiment, neurotransmitters in each of your cochleas is pulsing an electric signal to your brain at the frequency of the sound wave being provided to each ear. When binaural beats are played through headphones, your dense skull stops the two sound waves from combining directly into a lower frequency acoustic beat, but you still hear the pulsing, don't you? This happens because the electrical signals from each ear combine into one electrical signal on their way down the auditory nerve, and the brain perceives the combined wave as a sound we recognize and understand, though that actual sound wave did not exist, only its inputs. Whether auditory stimulation is from an acoustic beat played outside the body or a binaural beat played with stereo headphones, the physiology of the ear creates electromagnetic waves of identical characteristics to that of the sound waves it captures and amplifies. If the acoustic or binaural beat is stable, of a loud enough decibel, and experienced for a significant enough length of time, then brainwave patterns change in response to the auditory stimulation. This experiment is using a 7 Hz binaural beat, which is in the 4 to 8 Hz theta brainwave range. Theta brainwaves are associated with creativity, relaxation, enhanced learning, and better memory. People use binaural beats to change their brainwave frequencies for different physiological and psychological effects. The consciousness-changing effects of binaural beats are best experienced when in a calm state of mind, meditation being best. And with this video, I hope you were able to directly feel the effects of this experiment. Are you relaxed, and have you remembered what I taught you? I think so, as the 7 Hz binaural beat played during this demonstration will have boosted your learning capability and enhanced your memory by increasing theta brainwave activity. You can show your thanks for this rapid information learning by clicking the like button and subscribing to my channel, where you'll find other interesting scientific phenomenon researched and taught by me. If you would like to experiment more with binaural beats and with different frequencies, I have long tracks in my binaural beats playlist on the left. Or you can continue the experiment by upgrading this 7 Hz binaural beat into a 7.83 Schumann Resonance binaural beat. Thanks for participating, boost those brainwaves, and have a great day.